Mazda Skyactiv X review. The revolution begins with a squeeze bang. The matte black Skyactiv X prototype looks like a rough Mazda 3, perhaps reconstructed after a bad wreck by an over-enthusiastic owner of a spot welder and lots of gaffers tape. Rip ducts poke out of the dash, sending two breaths of conditioned air to no one in particular. Even its revolutionary engine, the thing we're here to experience, is entombed in a massive, nondescript cover to mask its unseemly noises. It's wild, strange way to meet a very unconventional vehicle that promises diesel-like fuel economy, a wide torque band, and an exotic method for burning less gas than ever before. It takes a few hours for Mazda's engineers to explain the fundamental principles of operation. For more detail, read our Skyactiv X Spark Control Compression Ignition Explainer, but here's a very brief overview. Skyactiv X marries some traditional gasoline engine characteristics with a novel form of compression ignition called SPCCI. The key for Skyactiv X is to use very high compression in the cylinder and an extremely lean fuel-air mixture, squeezed right to the cusp of getting hot enough to blow up all on its own, which is very hard to predict. A squirt of extra gas and a spark interject across that compression ignition threshold in a controlled and predictable manner. See the animation below. That takes a few essential components to get just right. One is a massive amount of computer processing power and some pressure sensors in the individual cylinders, because the ambient conditions change how and when these things happen. Skyactiv X uses a clutched supercharger to pump in additional air when needed to nail the mixture precisely, and high-pressure injectors to get the low ratios of fuel to disperse properly in the chamber. And since it operates like a conventional gasoline engine sometimes, it uses valve timing to lower the very high compression ratio so it doesn't reach combustion ignition in that mode. In practice, the Skyactiv X runs in compression ignition mode most of the time. In practical terms, that means it drives like a torquey gasoline Skyactiv engine. The torque curve is broad and flat diesel-like in the respect. That also means it can get away with using a 6-speed transmission and a lower final drive for better response. There's enough grunt and economy together that Mazda can let the engine spin faster at 60 mph. It's running at roughly 1000 more RPM than a similar gas engine, with greater efficiency. Mazda Skyactiv X. Skyactiv X is complex, and Mazda Vice President of R&D and Design Masashi Otsuka admits it will be an expensive engine to build. But, he said to us before we drove the cars, with a big lopsided smile, it's less expensive than a hybrid. That speaks to Mazda's philosophy in building the Skyactiv engine range in general. Mazda has avoided electrification almost entirely. What electrification it employs is either very minimal, i.e. loop regenerative braking and capacitor system, or niche, demi-EV, with its rotary range extender option. Rather than build a bunch of hybrids and EVs that are dependent on incentives to sell, and still don't sell that well, Mazda does have a point here. The company decided long ago to just improve the internal combustion engine as much as possible. That means it has the lowest average EPA fuel economy of any manufacturer. Although its overall volume is small, its sales have suffered recently, and it doesn't sell any large and inefficient SUVs or trucks. Mazda's strategy is technically sound, but perhaps not as effective in the real world as it might hope. Then again, as the company is eager to point out, neither is the real-world economy of the downsized, turbocharged engine trend. They're great at EPA testing but miserably thirsty in the real world.